Hey there, e-commerce superstar. Do you wish you could know what kind of content actually makes your audience tick? What makes them take action, read, click, and convert? You are in luck. My name is Kasey, and in this video, we'll talk about email A-B testing, including testing rules, metrics to test, and the technical part of how to actually set it all up. This video is brought to you by Drip. Trusted by more than 30,000 e-commerce marketers, Drip unleashes the power of your customer data to deliver perfectly personalized email and SMS marketing strategies that are proven to grow your revenue. Learn more at drip.com. So, what is A-B testing anyway? Well, it's when you send two or more variations of an email to samples of your audience and then compare performance metrics, click rate or open rate, to learn what kind of content worked better for your audience. As you can imagine, the more emails resonate with your audience, the more they buy and come back. And your learnings can also inform other marketing channels, leading to more revenue for your e-commerce store all around. Yay! Traditionally, there's been two metrics you could test with email: open rate and click rate. If you're wondering which subject line will get more of my people to open this email, or at which send time will I reach more of my audience, then you want to run a split test where open rate is the winning criteria. The open rate tests, they're changing though. In the fall of 2021, Apple and other tech giants started cracking up on consumers' privacy, and as a result, we marketers can't test open rates as accurately anymore because we can't track them. Because of that, open rate A-B tests are actually not as reliable right now. Which takes us to the second metric, click rate. What do you think would do better, an image of your product or user-generated content? The best way to know is to run an A-B test and let your readers show you, with their clicks, what content moves them better. Here are a few other things you could test and set click rate as your winning criteria. CTA in the button, the position of the button or the image in your email, different copy, and a completely different design template altogether. There's something else you could test with email, and that is your conversion rate. Tell me, have you ever debated whether you should offer a percentage off, discount, or free gift with order for a sale? Or what positioning or messaging will convert better? That's the time to run an A-B test and look at which variation brought in more revenue or had a higher conversion rate. Hey, if you're finding this content valuable, please hit that subscribe button under the video. All it's going to do is help you find my videos easier and help me continue producing them. And while you're there, just like this video for a complete awesomeness package. Thank you so much. Now that you know what metrics to test, it's time to look at how to test them so you're getting reliable results. Number one, test only one element at a time. That way you can actually see which element moved the needle. Number two, have a goal in mind. Don't just test for the sake of testing. Have a clear hypothesis or a question that will be answered with this test. Use the same types of subscribers. Raise your hand or comment below if you've ever tested customers versus non-customers for two variants. If so, then of course your results will differ wildly. That's why you need to make sure each test segment is composed of similar types of subscribers. Four, have large enough test segments. There's a great deal of science in all of this A-B testing business. And if you want to get statistically significant results, translation to human language, reliable results, you want to send each variation to a big enough sample. The size of your sample will really depend on the overall size of the list. However, it should at least be 1,000 people, and better yet, 3,000 people. When you have fewer people, your test results may end up being a fluke. Finally, number five, record test results. A-B testing is useless if you're testing all the time and not implementing what you learn. Create a spreadsheet and keep track of all of your learnings. All right, ready to see these tips in action? I'm going to share a real A-B test we did with one of our partners. If you watched one of my other videos, you'll know that 70% of people abandon the checkout process. 70. That's why abandoned cart emails are key in helping shoppers overcome hesitations and getting you to scoop up that revenue. And that's why we run this A-B test. All three variations you'll see on the screen feature the abandoned products, but here's how they're different. Variation A features product reviews. Variation B features a section about product materials and their benefits for the customer. And finally, variation C only shows the abandoned products, but neither of the other blocks. Here, we just wanted to see if getting right to the point with a simple reminder would be best.
Ooh.
Can you guess which metric we used to determine the winner? If you said click rate, you're right. When we test different email content, click rate is the winning criteria we want to pick. Now that you know A/B testing best practices, let's actually set one up together in Drip. We'll do an A/B test for a single campaign. The first thing you want to do is actually prep your campaign. Then, when you have your control variation ready, click Done Editing, and you'll be taken to this page where you just need to scroll down a little bit and you'll see this option to add split test variations. Once you click through, Drip will ask what you want to test, subject line or email content. Let's do the subject line first. Click Add Variation at the bottom and set another subject line. You can add multiple variations, but just remember that you need to have enough subscribers for each variation if you want to get reliable results. Now let's click Edit Settings. We've covered the winning criteria for various tests in this video, so this one should be easy. Test pool size tells you what portion of your send segment you want to use for the test. For example, if you have 10,000 people total on your list and you pick 30%, then the variations will be split between 3,000 people, and then the winning variation will be sent to the rest of them. Test duration is simply how long you want to wait before Drip determines the results. If you wanted to test email content instead, just pick email content at the top and set the winning criteria to be the click rate. And that's it. You should now be totally equipped to run some juicy email A/B tests. Let me know in the comments what's the first thing you want to test for your audience. As always, thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to subscribe so that you see more of them in your feed. I'll see you in the next one.